Welcome back, Truth Seeker. Want to talk about the very clear parallel between September 11th, 2001 and the World Health Organization declaring coronavirus a global pandemic March 11th, 2020, nearly 19 full years later. Again, 19 is a very special number. On September 11th, they told you that there were 19 hijackers and not arbitrarily. To begin with 19, there's something about time and that number. Every 19 years, the moon does a perfect reset in the sky. So the moon's placement on January 1st, 2001, for example, is the exact same as January 1st, 2020. And then it'll be the same 19 years later in the year 2039. And then 19 years later in 2058. So every 19 years, the moon syncs up with the dates in the Gregorian calendar year. This is why Jewish holidays fall on the exact same dates 19 years apart, which might remind you of the dancing Israelis on September 11, 2001. Speaking of Judaism, they have the practice of coding numbers into words. It's called gematria. It comes from Jewish mysticism Kabbalah. Kabbalah states God created the world with letters, numbers, and words. And gematria is the practice of coordinating words with matching numerical values and using them in rituals in accordance with dates in the calendar year. So I want you to see something. From September 11th, 2001 to March 11th, 2020, the date coronavirus was called a global pandemic, is exactly 222 months, 222, which is a special number. In gematria, Wuhan coronavirus equals 222. Freemasonry, which is based in Kabbalah, has a motto. That motto is order out of chaos, which also sums to 222. And I see the mistake I made on the screen. Do you see how Wuhan coronavirus is 222? It also has a numerical value of 78. And let me put this up on the screen for you. Wuhan coronavirus, 222 and 78. So coming back, order out of chaos, 222 and 78. New York, New York, 222 and 78. New York alone also, 78. The Masonic motto is order out of chaos. And you've heard politicians say it many times before, never let a good crisis go to waste. This phrase fits in with the motto, order out of chaos. And this is how Masonry operates in high places. They create problems to bring about their planned solution or agenda. And oftentimes, that's starting a war, as they did after September 11th. And you might recall that at the beginning of 2020, when the coronavirus headlines were coming out, so were headlines about nearly missing World War III with Iran. So 222 months on the nose from September 11th to March 11th. This is not an accident. Remember, the Event 201 simulation, October 18th, 2019. That was put on by the World Economic Forum along with the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and Johns Hopkins University, and it was done in New York, New York. And in case you missed it, one more time, New York, New York is 222 and 78, like order out of chaos, like Wuhan coronavirus. But the World Economic Forum out of Switzerland, where the banks are, that are making big profits right now off all the lending throughout the world because of the coronavirus economic shutdowns, this organization has that same gematria. And here you'll notice the 93. This is when you run the alphabetic order in reverse with the rules of numerology, the 93. Not an arbitrary number. Think about the World Trade Centers and the 93 World Trade Center bombing. 93 is a number that represents time, represents Saturn, the keeper of time. Also the sun, which is said to be 93 million miles away. So again, you have to say, what are the odds of these things for them to be so perfectly coordinated? And if it was random, the odds would be astronomical. But the thing is, it's not random. All of this is being coordinated by the cabal. And that term cabal comes from Kabbalah, which again is where gematria comes from, the practice of coding numbers into words and using them ritualistically, numbers and words. Now, I just want to remind people about this. The first case found in the U.S. was January 21st in Seattle, Washington, in the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation's backyard. Of course, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation in King County. Corona means crown. Kings wear crowns. The Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation's directly across the street from the Space Needle, the Big Needle. And they're talking about making the vaccine to stop such a pandemic in the future, which Bill Gates has been talking about since even before any of this happened. But anyhow, January 21st, 121, coronavirus outbreak 121, Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation 121. Again, January 21st, the first case in the U.S., and that was identified by the CDC. And notice the head of the CDC, Robert Ray Redfield, with a July 10th birthday. The date that first case was found, from the day that it was declared a global pandemic, March 11th, to his upcoming birthday, 121 days. From the date of a global pandemic. And by the way, coronavirus pandemic equals 113. 11/3, March 11th. You might recall in 2002, that was the day the Tribute in Light happened. The massive purple beams in New York City paying tribute to the fallen World Trade Centers. They now light those purple beams up annually on September 11th. But that first case of Wuhan coronavirus, it was in Seattle, Washington, the home of the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. We did a video that day, and I again reminded about the history of this nation and a certain number which ties New York and Seattle together, and that number is 68. The word Wuhan equals 68, like Seattle, Washington. And remember, the construction firm that built the World Trade Center's Magnuson Clemencic Associates, they're headquartered out of Seattle. They built the World Trade Centers that fell on September 11, 2001, and they began construction in 1968, the same year 911 was made the national emergency dialing code, the same year George W. Bush graduated from Yale and Skull and Bones, the same year 2001 A Space Odyssey came out, the same year the New York Jets had their only Super Bowl winning season, the same year Boeing debuted their commercial jumbo jetliner, and of course Boeing's a Seattle company too. So Seattle and New York, very important in the 9/11 ritual, and now years later, very important in the Wuhan coronavirus ritual. Because again, these are the two cities that are considered the epicenters of the outbreak in the U.S. with the most cases. And isn't it funny that we talked about this the night of, and now here we are, where these are the facts. The date January 21st can also be written 21/1, like 211, the 47th prime. Seattle's on the 47th parallel. The Masons have the compass set at 47 degrees in tribute to the 47th problem of Euclid about how to establish foundation. Think of building 7, 47 floors tall that fell on September 11th, 8 hours after Towers 1 and 2. But just understand, all of these numbers are part of ritual. And notice Seattle, Washington also sums to 212, like the New York area code. With regards to the 68, the word terror has gematria of 68 and 94. Seattle, Washington has gematria of 68 and 94. Coronavirus pandemic has gematria of 94 as well. The World Trade Center's construction began in 68, and they opened officially April 4th, 1973. April 4th is the 94th day of the year. So the World Trade Center's opened on the 94th day of the year after construction began in 68. The numbers that connect to terror, that connect to Seattle, Washington, where the construction firm was, that connect to coronavirus pandemic. And again, we see how 9/11 and this global pandemic are perfectly synced. And again, they're bringing fear into people's lives. They're shutting down economies again. They're shutting down travel again. They're interrupting the way people live again for the sake of an agenda that is done by the numbers. That's why we had a national emergency on 911 in our faces. Remember how we were talking about 121? It has a square root of 11. 11 is the master number in numerology. New York is the 11th state. Happened on the 11th of the month. The World Trade Centers look like massive 11s. They've said the first flight that hit was AA11. This is our moment, true seeker, to wake up the sleeping masses. You know, they don't necessarily have to understand the numbers to get it. They just have to think about the major parallels, the historical facts. But the numbers really are the cement that brings the ritual together, that fully exposes it. Again, just to remind people about 1968. Just give you the visuals. February 16th, that's the 47th day of the year. That's the day the first 911 call was made in 68. World Trade Center construction began in August of 68. George W. Bush graduated from Yale and Skull and Bones in 68, and from his July 6th birthday to September 11th each year is a span of 68 days. The man who couldn't say the word terror enough. The New York Jets, that was their only Super Bowl winning season. 2001 A Space Odyssey came out on the 93rd day of the year, April 3rd. Boeing debuted their jumbo jetliner on September 30th, 9-3 again. Wuhan coronavirus, 93. Don't forget Tom Hanks of Sleepless in Seattle, a movie that came out in 93. He came down with coronavirus 121 days from his upcoming birthday. All jokes, all mockery, all ritual. This is the firm that built the World Trade Centers, Magnus and Klemenchik Associates. And this is what terrorism is. The original definition is government by intimidation. That's exactly what went on September 11th. It was blamed on a boogeyman in a cave. It was a lie. Now it's an invisible virus. Just like then, it was invisible terrorists. Don't forget Israel. 1967, after the Six-Day War, put out this commemorative coin to remember the Six-Day War. A plane flying at two objects that reminded the towers. A tank reminding you of war. Six-Day War 119, like New Jersey, like Star of David. The dancing Israelis arrested in New Jersey on the 11th day of the ninth month. Don't forget Tisha B'Av equals 911. That's the day to remember the destruction of the two temples. Tisha B'Av, 911 in Jewish gematria. Think about it. The dancing Israelis were arrested at the Doric apartment complex, which is 322, like the number of Yale Skull and Bones, like George W. Bush and his father were members of. That event divided up the religions and people of the world. And this year, on March 22nd, CNN put out this story, 322. Echoes of 9/11 as New Yorkers try to keep calm, but we can't quite carry on. This article was about what coronavirus is now doing to the city, with it being shut down on March 22nd, a day we predicted would see major shutdowns in the U.S. And of course, we are right again by understanding the code. That date can also be written 22/3, like 223, novel coronavirus 223. In Jewish gematria, Masonic is 223. So again, Truth Seeker, this is our chance to really wake people up, to explain to them the significance of these dates that have had major impacts on our lives that we're all living through right now. People are very stressed out right now, and this is why they need to wake up to what government really is. It's here to control them. It's here to steer them. It is not here to benefit them. It is here to use and abuse us. It is here to lie to us, propagandize us, tax us. It's never been here to help us. That is the myth that a lot of people need to stop swallowing. If they can't stop swallowing it, they deserve to suffer. And those are just facts as well, Truth Seeker. We got to wake these people up. We got to make this stand. When they open this country back up, we got to really pound the pavement and get everyone pounding the pavement nationwide. The agenda has to be up. The federal government has to be over. The news media has to be shut down. These are our demands. This is what has to happen for this world to be safe going forward. These people, they jeopardize our safety and our future. They need to be done away with. The Constitution says what to do with those who are treasonous. It needs to happen. Till next time, Truth Seeker.